Now that we've seen how we could grab some rows from our data frame, get the overall structure of it, let's get in and see how we could start to pull out different pieces of data. Now, you're going to notice about a data frame the fact that there's a lot of different methods and tools and so forth that are at your disposal for getting in and finding basically anything that you might want, performing all sorts of different manipulations and so forth. And we're going to take a look at a couple of these as we go through the next handful of videos here, but I want to stress the fact that we're not going to go through everything. If you go check out the documentation, linked to from our GitHub page, you'll be able to see everything that's available to you and begin to kind of just continue to grow your tool set. But let's get in and see how we can identify individual items or start slicing and dicing our data. So how can we go grab specific rows and specific columns, or how can we slice and or dice our data where we're grabbing full columns, full rows, etc.? Well, one way that we can do this is by grabbing a specific column by identifying it based on its name. That you'll notice that the indexer for DataFrame is going to, by default, be the name of the column. So if I say Airport City, that's going to give us back everything that's inside of that city column, as well as the index. So when I do that, boom, I've got my city, and I've got the index to go along with that. How about if I want two different columns? Well, if I want two different columns, then what I need to do is I need to actually pass in, where is my cursor here? Let me put that to red. There we go. Now I can find it. There we go. So what I can do is I can create a list, like I've got here, with the name of each column that I want. So you'll notice that I'm identifying my name and my country there, and so those are going to be the two columns that I want back. The main thing that I want you to notice about the syntax here is the fact that we're putting this inside of a list. If we didn't put that inside of a list, then what we're actually doing is passing in different parameters into that indexer, and that's not the way that it behaves. We want to pass in one parameter. That one parameter is going to be a list. So that that little bit of square bracket that you're seeing inside of there, that's got to be there. So that way we can identify, hey, these are the columns. Cool. So that's how I could get individual columns. Now, let's say that I want to go in and grab things based on their position. That sometimes I'm going to have the name, sometimes I'm going to have the column, that maybe what I'm trying to do is loop through things. Maybe I want to see where something is specifically inside of a data frame. Maybe I do happen to know the location, and so that's what I want to be able to go in and do. And this is especially helpful if maybe I want to specify a range of columns or a range of rows. So what I can do is I can use my iLocation or my index location, there we go. With my iLocation, my index location, now what I can do is specify the rows and the columns by index that I want. So if I do 00, like I've got right here, as you might expect, that's going to give us right here, Seattle, Tacoma. And so if I run this code, if you will, on my slide, that's what we're going to get back. If I say 22, that's going to count down again, zero base, so 012. It's actually going to give us the third and the third. That's going to give us, in this case, United Kingdom. Now, you might notice on the slide, and this will be true on the next couple of slides as well, that little spot right up there, that column 0, column 1, column 2, those are not actually part of the data frame. They're just there to help make our demo a little bit easier here. So that way you can see where 0, 1, and 2 actually are. So 0, 0, Seattle, Tacoma, 2, 2 is going to give us the United Kingdom there. You can also go in and specify a range. And this is what I was mentioning before, where things are actually a little bit more powerful when you're using that index location is the ability to specify a range of values. So similar to using a range on, say, a list, where I could go in and specify 1: and then whatever my end index is going to wind up being, maybe for example 4, I can do the exact same thing here. So let's start off by using ::. When I pass in those ranges on either side, or in this case, both sides, what I'm indicating is that I want all of the values from my rows or my columns. So if you remember from before, the first parameter, that's going to indicate the rows that I want. Second parameter, that's going to indicate the columns that I want. When I say ::, I'm saying all rows and all columns. So if I ran this, I'm going to get back that highlighted section there where I'm going to get everything. If I said, hey, I only want, in my case, the first 2 rows, so it's going to be 0, 1, and then stopping at index 2, but not including it, then I could go in and specify that as my range. This is now going to indicate that we want back all of our columns. So if I run this, I'm now going to get back Seattle, Tacoma, Seattle, USA, and Dulles, Washington, USA as my values back. So first 2 rows and all columns. I could go the other direction as well, where maybe I put that over on the column side. So now that's going to give me back the first 2 columns. So that's going to give me back the name and the city. And we get our index as well. How about if I want to specify a list of items there? So maybe what I want to get back is I want to get back the first column and, in my case, the third column. Remember again, counting starts at 0, so 0 and 2, column 0 and column 2. The way that I can do that is by specifying a list. And I want to highlight here the difference between a range and a list. My range allows me to specify the starting point and the end point, whereas my list here is going to give me the ability to specify the individual items that I want here. So in my case, I want the first column and I want the third column, so 0 and 2. 2, there we go. I'm going to specify 0 and 2. Those are the columns that I want back. You'll notice the colon at the beginning, that's going to specify that we want all of the rows. So if I run this, now what I'm going to get is my name and my country, and again, the index as well. If you want to do this by name, then you could just simply use location, so just LOC, and now if I specify name and country, that would give me back the exact same but only doing it by name instead of by the index. All right, well, now that we've seen a little bit of a slide representation, what do you say we see this in action? Let's open up a notebook and see how we can actually use these tools.